This is the universe, or at least a portion of it. It is an intricate dance between galaxies, stars, and black holes. But between the web of matter, there are black dots straining the marvellous orange and purple filaments. But what are these dots? Could they be empty voids of nothingness? We know now that mass is not evenly distributed throughout the universe, and empty spaces will naturally occur over time as a continuously unfolding time and space pushes the static mass, galaxies, and galaxy clusters into characteristic structures called sheets, filaments, and nodes. It was Albert Einstein who first suggested that there is more to these patches of nothingness than meets the eye, though he would later redact the idea of a cosmological constraint from his work. But whether he realized it or not, Einstein was onto something. Could there really be nothing? This was a question raised by the ancient Greek philosopher Parmenadies. He believed that there could never really be nothing because it cannot exist in a plenum. But this was far from the truth, as we shall see. The Boetius void, aka the Great Nothing, is an enormous spherical region of space containing very few galaxies. It's located near the constellation Boetes. That's why we associate this region by this name. It's nearly 330 million light years in diameter, and this void is the largest void in the universe that was discovered by Robert Kirschner during the galactic redshift. It's approximately 700 million light years far from Earth. You will find so many results from Google showing a dark empty area at Boetes void, but that's actually a dark nebula Barnard 68, which doesn't allow light to pass through. It has been also theorized that such voids are created by mergers of smaller voids. If we calculate roughly about one galaxy every 10 million light years, then there should be 2,000 galaxies in the Boetes void. Yes, there are galaxies in the Boetes void. Voids are nothing but an extremely massive scale of space between enormous large structures of the universe like galaxy filaments. Voids technically do not mean complete void, but they are those spaces in the universe where the density of the galaxy is less than observed in other parts, such as filaments. Voids, on average, are 100 megaparsecs of diameter. The Boetes void is around 34 to 50 megaparsecs in diameter, but there is an enormously large void called the KBC void, which is around 2 billion light years across. There are many large voids that are discovered, and opposite to it, many superclusters, galaxy filaments, such as Hercules, Corona, Borealis, Great Wall, which indicates that they must be part of a system, and many such are waiting to be discovered. Thus, this all should be part of a much bigger system. There's an excellent article in the current issue of Sky and Telescope about our local void, or LV. If you look at the center of the Milky Way, in the constellation Sagittarius, you are looking in the direction of this void that lies on the far side of our galaxy. Actually, the large part of the space of our universe compromises voids. However, when the term void is used, it does not mean a void is totally empty of galaxies. There are feeble galaxies in these voids and, in the case of LV, there is one confirmed dwarf galaxy, KK246, that astronomers can study with the Hubble telescope. If we were able to travel to LV, we would aim our spaceship roughly towards the center of the Milky Way. This would be our itinerary. In 27,000 light years, we speed past the Milky Way's black hole, Sagittarius A, another 100,000 light years to reach the far edge of the Milky Way. In another 10 million light years, we come to KK246, which is so isolated, there is nothing within 10 million light years in any direction. Ahead of us is darkness extending out to 250 million light years. There could be as many as 10 more dwarf galaxies in this space, but they have not been confirmed yet. Well, that's it. There's not much more for us to see, so we cut a U-turn and head back. The LV is getting larger in the sense that surrounding galaxies are pulled away from it by the gravity of their own galactic cluster. And the gravity exerted from large galactic clusters such as the Virgo cluster, the Great Attractor, and the Shapley concentration. The Boetes void is somewhat larger than LV, 330 million light years in diameter, versus the LV's 250 million light years. The reason voids are cooler is that temperature, as defined, is the movement of atoms or molecules. Since the mass density of a void may be as little as 1% of the mean mass density of the universe, there's much less to heat up relative to the cosmic microwave background. In fact, It is thought that all voids in the universe are getting larger as galaxies move towards one another in the clusters and filaments connecting these clusters. Here is a computer simulation of the universe, showing how galaxies tend to concentrate in the clusters or filaments. The black areas are voids that are growing larger as galaxies concentrate in the clusters or filaments. There is no definitive answer, but the clues we have give us some idea of what may be responsible for its formation. The universe, as we can see it, has matter coalescing into web shapes. That is to say, most galaxies and other matter we observe outside of our own Milky Way galaxy are part of apparent streams of matter, clustering into strands and knots. The Hercules supercluster forms part of the edge of the void, and there are 60 observed galaxies within the void itself, and these galaxies form a rough tube through the center of the void. So this is consistent with the strand and void pattern we have observed in the overall universe, which I showed at the beginning of the video, and is also consistent within the cosmic microwave background observations of this region of space. So there doesn't appear to be a large population of dusts or gases loosely populating this region either. While we can't truly account for the history of this void via current astronomical models, to a level of surety beyond reasonable objections, we do see that it follows a certain repeated pattern in the universe, and it isn't the largest void to be sure. If you look at the Wikipedia list of astronomical voids, the Boutez void is the second to last in a list of almost 40 voids. On a superficial observation, one may see such a phenomenon caused by some very old rare type of yet undiscovered mega ancient supernova event type. On a really fantastical assertion, however, the void was originally filled with many stars to begin with, and such stars have been harvested by surrounding ET civilizations to the point of total extinction, which eventually create the void. Or that the Boutez system is full of intelligent ET life, and they wanted to create a cosmic superhighway so they could travel relatively unimpeded through the void. So all the surrounding systems agreed to start harvesting the matter or energy that was once in the void. The reason we do not hear intelligent signals from there could be for various reasons. One, their technology is too advanced and does not function like ours being silent. Number two, the distance makes intelligent signals hard to reach Earth other than random degenerated waves that appear as noise. And number three, such civilizations reside in the hyperspatial domain. So many movements and activities that would emit radiation as we know it is not evident. Then again, the Boutez void could just be a natural part of cosmic formation. By the best estimates, and backed by observational data, these voids are expected counterparts of the strands of galaxies we observe as the constituents of superclusters and normal clusters. If the Milky Way were in the center of the Boutez void, astronomers would not have been able to observe any other galaxies until the 1960s. But perhaps the most interesting fact is that if you were placed smack bang in the middle of the void in a spacesuit, the nearest galaxy or light source would be so tremendously far away that everything around you would be eternally black, up, down, left, right, wherever you look regardless of orientation. Now try imagining that. So there you are, guys. I hope this video offers some good insight. If you enjoyed it, be sure to hit the like button and subscribe for more content like this. And as always, thanks for watching.